Before 1980, scientists and engineers could not see features as small as atoms. But in 1981, a group working for IBM in Switzerland were able to produce the first scanning tunneling microscope. And in 1982, they were able to actually characterize the surface of some silicon metal. One way of representing this experiment is to take an ordinary refrigerator magnet. Yeah, I know, this one's a whole lot bigger than the ones you're used to, but it does the same basic principle. If we take a portion off of that refrigerator magnet and call it the probe strip, and we turn our magnet over such that we have the dark to dark with our probe and our magnet and drag it in this direction and in this direction, we get a different feel. Now, one of the possible patterns is the same pole all over the surface, or it might have alternating poles in this stripe pattern that we see here, or it might be checkerboard. Now the question to you is, which is the correct response? If you say that it is the stripe pattern, you are correct. Speaking of a silicon surface, here we see an image that was taken here at the University of Wisconsin by Mac Legale's group, and it shows various different step layers of silicon atoms. They're not all on the same level. We have some that are a little higher than others, and if you look very closely, there's some dark spots that represents holes in the surface, depressions where an atom is not found. Here we see another image, this one created by a different scientist at IBM. He took a copper surface, and onto that copper surface he deposited a series of iron atoms. Now, as he used the probe of his atomic force microscope, you can see that he began to arrange them in a circle. Here we see an artist rendering of what Don Eigler ultimately did. He arranged his atoms all in a perfect circle, and the thing that is so impressive about this is that in the center of this circle we have a standing wave as a result of the electron structure in the copper. Here we have a probe strip, and we're going to emulate what Don Eigler did using pieces of our refrigerator magnet that have pieces of double stick foam in between the two layers of magnet. Here we have a Lego model of a magnetic force microscope. We call this our magnetic force macroscope. Now, it has many of the same features as the microscope version. It has a laser that points at a reflective surface, in this case a small piece of mirror, that rides on a movable cantilever probe. Below that is our sample, in this case a series of magnets, and they reside on a so-called XY transfer table that can move this direction and can move this direction, and in so doing give us the complete surface of the material. The laser beam, once it bounces off the reflective surface, goes to a detector some distance away, and that exaggerated motion shown on the detector is picking up the very subtle motions of the cantilever probe. The probes in these various different scanning microscopy techniques have to be near atomically sharp. Imagine, if you will, taking your elbow and rubbing it across the surface of this table, and then comparing the result of taking your finger and rubbing it across the surface of this table. With your finger, you get a much better impression of the texture of that surface. Here we see a surface with a few atoms spaced across on the top of that surface. If we take a probe that is not atomically sharp and try to move across this surface, we're not going to get very good detail. Whereas here we have an atomically sharp probe, and it will be able to move across and sense that position of that individual atom, and then later this layer of atoms.